Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and this is a guitar amplifier from Ashdown. This is the AGM-5C. And this is the first time I've played an AGM guitar amplifier from Ashdown. There's a number of models in the range created by amp guru Dave Green, and it's the perfect mix of classic, iconic, vintage British valve amp tones, but with some modern tech. And that's what you want, because old valve amps, in my humble opinion, sound fantastic, but they're a bit unreliable and they don't really do a lot. With this amplifier, you get that tone, but with some fun features I'll talk about shortly. It makes you want to play big chords and let them ring out. So it's an all-valve 5-watt amplifier, and like I said, lovely old-school British valve-driven tone, even at 5 watts. And there's something cool as well, it has a stealth button which brings it down to 1 watt, so you can get that massive tone. It also cleans up beautifully as well, and it's a great pedal platform. You'll hear some cleans in a second, as well as some overdrive pedals. But you can get that beautiful, thick, saturated tone at only 1 watt, so you haven't got to blow the windows out of your house. So that's the first bit of modern tech. Now let's get into more traditional amplifier controls. Up top, you are greeted with a gain control and a 3-band EQ, bass, middle and treble, a master volume control so you can control the overall volume of your fantastic AGM-5C, a mix control, and some of the nicest reverb you've heard in a very long time. I forgot to mention, I was gonna say this at the start, I totally forgot. This is hand built in the UK in Ashdown's custom shop. Now, Ashdown aren't a big company for the amount of stuff that they do and the amount of gear that they create used by artists all over the world. From Wembley Stadium to your local pub on the corner, you are probably going to find an Ashdown product. And this is made in the UK custom shop, and it's not custom shop money. Other traditional features which you find on the AGM-5C are an effects loop, which you'll find on the top of the amplifier as opposed to around the back. Quite a quirky place to put it, but Ashdown are a very quirky, awesome company, so why not put it on the top? And on the far right, you will see, what's it called again, a VCA meter? It's Ashdown's kind of staple. It's the little dial which goes back and forth when your tone is more distorted. It kind of clips at the top end. It's really cool. The final bit of traditional features I want to talk about are simply the fact that the valves themselves are JJ Electronics. Great quality valves, 12AX7 in the preamp, EL84 in the power amp section, and the lovely speaker is a Celestion Creamback, and you're hearing it mic'd up with an Aston microphone Spirit. Yes, Spirit, the little one, the Origin. Origin, and an SM57 from the Fine Folk at Shure. I'm using 2 Atec cables and my Kramer Pacer as well. So now let's talk about modern things before we will hear it in a second. I mentioned the power reduction stealth button earlier, moving it from 5 watts to 1 watt. This also activates Ashdown's ASC, active speaker compensation, which means the harder you push a speaker, the better it sounds, because it's physically pushing more air bouncing off the walls going into your lovely ears. But this active speaker compensation compensates for the tone loss when reducing the wattage, but still makes it sound fantastic at that lower wattage. Essentially, it's just witchcraft, really. I'm not going to go into depth of how it works. It's just witchcraft from the UK Ashdown custom shop. Some more modern features. On the right-hand side of the top panel, you will find a record out, auxiliary in, and a headphone output, alongside a big speaker mute switch. Now, if 1 watt is still too loud for you, you can mute the speaker itself, and there's an internal load box, so you're not going to blow anything up by physically muting the amplifier, but still having it turned on. You can run a line from the record out into any recording software you like and record with the tones from your Ashdown without having to mic it up or even turn it on. Use it with headphones through your recording software if your heart desires. If not, just use the headphone output built on the amplifier and play along with backing tracks. Plug in your auxiliary device, play along with backing tracks through the Celestion Creamback. It's an amazing little amp. And that's enough chatting, let's hear it some more. The gain is at 1 o'clock, all the EQ is flat and there's just a smidge of reverb. Thank you. So even though it's one channel, it cleans up beautifully with the input is very responsive to what's hitting it, so it cleans up beautifully with the volume on your guitar. Gain is now a quarter of the way up, so like 2-3. That's a beautiful EL84 drive. It's chimey, it's warm, it's chewy. All the guitar words. Very touch responsive. So volume of your guitar, it's reactive too, but also how hard and the dynamic in which you pick. Keep doing that because it just sounds great. There's some crazy overtones happening when you rock the air. I might need to intonate this Kramer though. Anyways, let's crank the gain because I can. Bridge pickup. With this being an all-valve UK custom shop build amplifier that is this touch responsive, it's gonna lap up pedals. So hold the thought a second. I'm gonna put the gain down at 1 o'clock. And get a tube screamer. I'm back and I have a TS9 on the floor. The gain is, I'm kind of using it a bit as a clean boost, just a little bit of seasoning on top. The gain is at 10 o'clock, the level is at 1 o'clock, and the tone is all is halfway up in the middle. It still cleans up beautifully. Turn the gain up now on the tube screamer. So it's Level and gainer are 2 o'clock, like 7, 8, and the tone is still in the middle. This is it off. Amplify. This thing feels just as good as it sounds under your fingertips. And if you don't get what I mean by how an amp feels, you need to play an Ashdown AGM-5C because it feels like butter under your fingers. It's fantastic. Let me know down below in the comments what you think of this Ashdown AGM-5. There's a number of different models in the like wattages and sizes in the lineup. And I'm guessing each are just going to sound as good as the last because this is the first time I've dipped my toe into the world of Ashdown guitar amps. And I'm very, very impressed. Comment down below what you think of this fantastic little amplifier. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on the Ashdown AGM-5C, or any Ashdown product for that matter, bass amps, pedals, they make basses now which are utterly fantastic, get your fine self to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, it's been a pleasure as always. I'll see you next time.